Hello everyone, Suzy Gaming here and welcome back to another CROSSOUT episode. And as you know, 10.60 is finally up. Sorry for the delay, I'm working full time trying to survive in real life. But anyway, this is the biggest patch that I've seen for a long time.
So first of all, they nerfed the decors. They will no longer absorb the damage. The damage will directly pass to the part where decor is attached. They also remodeled the map called Control 17 Station. The road path is not the same anymore. And also we of course have this new Famine Horseman. With Deluxe Edition you're getting the new Anger and extra paint. So the Deluxe Edition costs $64.99 and the normal one costs $29.99. I mean, nothing special here except cabin. If you really want to test out the cabin, you can buy it from in-game market. Current price, it's $15.46. It's cheaper than Step Spider. Looks like many people don't like it. I mean, it's a situational cabin. It's deadly sometimes, sometimes not. Depends what type of vehicle enemy uses. Because yeah, if you have a mobile enemy in front of you, there's no chance you're gonna activate that perk. If you're playing above 10k, there's tons of slow enemies there, then yes, you might hit the 25% damage bonus. We have tons of buffs and nerfs. Let's check them out. Bastion. Hand skill, Indomitable. Now affects the cabin bastion. Jade skill medium heavyweight now affects the cabin Foran. Melee weapon of Cerberus is a separated melee weapon now. Tormentor will be useful with it. That's a really nice buff. Step Spider, the cabin's perk increases the maximum speed of mechanical legs by 10 kilometers per hour. Maximum speed of mechanical legs increased to 40 kilometers per hour. All tower cannons can be mounted on the sides and under the bottom of the armored car. Revolver Corvo. So the first buff is now every engine affects Corvo, so it can decrease the reloading time. The perk of Echo Cabin also increases the speed of reloading weapons. Anyway, I hope Corvo users are happy, but this weapon is still not in my top 10 list. Single shot. Shotguns. Junkbow, Fafnir, Nidhogg. I'm showing you the GIF right now. It shows the shotguns before and after. So as you can see, four shrapnels are going outside of the aiming spot. But if you're gonna look at the old spread, 3 out of 5 shots, all of them are inside aim zone. Now your shots are going to be spreaded. And if my calculations are correct, this will decrease your kill time. Because now it depends on distance between you and enemy. It will take much longer to kill that enemy, just because you don't have enough focused shots. So for example, you're aiming for flying drones. Now sometimes you're not gonna be able to one-shot it immediately because of this new spread mechanic. Again, it depends on distance as well. If you're that close, you're gonna be able to take them. But if you're quite far away, it will be much, much harder. So I'm considering this nerf for all single shot shotguns. Anyway, enough with shotguns. Tackler. While the perk is active, the machine gun additionally gets 50% resistance to thermal damage. Still sucks. Whirlwind and Cyclone. Projectile explosion rate is increased by 20 centimeters. Reaper minigun. Weapon durability increased by 18%. A really serious buff. And now guys, here's the sad news. They nerfed Spark 3 really badly. The time required to deal maximum negative effect on the enemy has been increased from 1.5 to 4 seconds. So now they have 2 times more chance to run away from you. The parts perk has been changed also. When dealing damage, reduces the power and speed of the enemy's car, as well as weapon reloading speed, 6% for 1 second. The effect stacks up to 12 times. Now the emitter reduces the target's movement speed and weapon reloading speed to 72%. Now, if we're gonna consider the hitting of the Spark 3, this number might change, so don't be scared. Typhoon. So that means, if you remember my Typhoon video, I was recommending to separate your buttons so you can repeatedly slow down the enemy. But now they put it 5.5 seconds between each shot, so you will not be able to repeatedly slow down your enemy no more. Again, same as Spark 3, now enemy can escape from your rapid fire much easier. And here is my favorite one, the return of the king from the ashes. Welcome the Scorpion. Increased weapon accuracy when standing and in motion. But forget about standing, motion is important here, because yes, 95% accuracy is completely back. I'm talking about hover scorpions. Old times, Scorpion is back. And here is the nerf, base damage reduced by 15%. And they also reduce the penalty of the penetration, that means damage will go much deeper. But still, I played some matches. If you play with Neutrino Scope, you are god. Now, I'm talking to Scorpion users, if you practice enough to hitting the orange target, that means pinpoint accuracy. You have to keep practice, don't give up. If you hit orange targets, always, you'll get guaranteed MVP in 6 shots minimum. Because Scorpion projectile can still penetrate Goliath tracks, armor tracks. It still has some penetration power left. And that's enough for MVP gameplay. This is a really good decision because they literally killed Scorpions with one nerf. Like, before it was a god weapon, but with that nerf, they killed it. It was the cheapest relic weapon, almost close to the most expensive legendary weapon. And I understand that because people want to try Scorpion, they see that it sucks while moving, accuracy is horrible, you cannot do anything. I especially did a video about the Scorpion nerf, it was horrible. But now I can easily tell the king is back. Now obviously it's not that powerful as before 9.50 update, you know, because now hovers are nerfed, some power score changes, now it will guarantee kick you to the high power score matches, but at least we got the accuracy back. That's the most important thing. No matter what my speed is, the accuracy is 95%. So if you were about to sell your Scorpion, don't do it, because it's overpowered again. Only if you practice. It took me some time. I practiced 10 rounds, but after that, MVP is just dropping on me like a rain. It was so satisfying to see finally some generators blowing up. There was some matches that there were 3 Scorpion users in one team. It was horrible and kind of cheering because it's back. They finally treating Scorpion as it should be. Because they never planned to reducing the Scorpion's effectiveness that much. Like, Porcupine was much more expensive than Scorpion. If you said that in closed alpha, I would have laughed so hard. But now Scorpion is back. Now it's again the most expensive weapon in CROSSOUT market, as it's supposed to be. Now I'm warning Scorpion users, disable the chat, cause salty kids are back. They will call you cheater, they will curse your family, give you some headache. Just get those MVPs, don't listen to anyone, kill every enemy you see, no mercy. Now I'm talking to the non-Scorpion owners, how to beat the Scorpion hover user. Well, first, if you have a chameleon, you already know the answer. If you don't have chameleon and you've seen a Scorpion projectile flying from spawn to spawn, you typing to the chat, can someone with cloak hunt down the Scorpion? In every match, there is at least 2 chameleon users. And the second way to beat hover Scorpion user is, no, it's not go to the forum and cry about it, but actually get into the action by yourself. Try to hunt it down, try to focus on it, stay behind the cover. As soon as he's not looking at you, attack with all what you got. If you have cannon, kill it with accuracy. If you have machine gun, cripple it, then slowly kill it. It's all about your skill. With practice, you will learn how to hunt these bastards easier. Upgrade the durability of generators, hide them really well. If you're hiding them beneath your build, add some armor around it. Cause trust me, 95% accuracy is not a joke, they will get that generator anyway. But yeah, now you're watching some Scorpion gameplay, you can easily see that accuracy is back. I'm playing with Hoverjet, Double Scorpion, Neutrino, Colossus Engine, and Chameleon. I think it's just on point because now Scorpion is a skill-based weapon. So if you're gonna shoot at the cabin, it will take ages to kill enemy. But if you're gonna hit the orange target, which is really hard because you need to aim at dot, at that little dot that shows where the generator is. And if enemy is moving, it's really hard. You need to practice for 10 matches, 20 matches. After that, you will get it. Use Scorpion with hovers. Forget about wheels, legs. That age is over. Scorpion hover. Mobile sniper is back. Anyway, now let's talk about Mandrake Incinerator. There's some sensitivity changes with X and Y axis. And after each shot, the scope will no longer return to the standard position. Porcupine Mine Lair, here's the beautiful buff, I really liked it. Now barrels are no longer destroyed by the Spark 3 emitter immediately after the shot from the mine laying machine. Because yeah, when I was shooting porcupines, if there's Spark user next to me, my barrels were just blowing on my face and damaging me. So thumbs up for that. Good job, devs. That's a beautiful and really smart buff. So they also changed characteristics of all bumpers. Some of them got really strong buffs. Some of them got nerfed. Power score, durability changes, ram damage changes. And the list is too long. I'll put it in the description and you can also check their other links as well. So hey guys, that was the all important news. Definitely the Scorpion buff and nerf was the biggest thing about this update. If you want to learn about new pack, video will be in the right upper corner. Nothing really did change since test server. 25% of damage bonus still remains. Tell me what you think about this update. But I'm gonna see you next time. Peace out.